Hey guys, we're out here in the garage again, next to Jordan's engineless motorcycle there. But Ethan just came over here, and we really couldn't believe it, because if you remember from the previous videos, he had a Kawasaki KX85. And he managed to get a guy to trade him this 450 Kawasaki just for that KX85 and a little pit bike was the deal, which is one hell of a deal. Actually, one of the best deals I've heard of recently.
Yeah, the guy texted me first about it. He texted me and he just put trade question mark, and I asked him for what, and he said KX450. And then I just asked what was wrong with it, got all like the specs from it. And
should have asked him what was wrong with him.
But I went to the house and he like was sitting there. He pulled it out of the shed and I started it and rode around the yard, and I looked at my dad and he said it runs perfectly fine. So I did, yeah. I did the deal. So.
It's a 2006 model. And the guy basically just wanted a couple smaller bikes for his kids, you know, for Christmas. So, and he said he had this big 450 and never rode it really. So he was willing to do the trade. And I think it's just a freaking amazing deal. I mean, 450 is about as good as it gets, obviously. And this one's set up really nice. And like you said, it runs great, fires right up. And it's a whole lot of power to get used to, isn't it?
It doesn't like to idle that much. I probably need to tune the carb or something, but otherwise, well, yeah, it's way more power than the 85. You can't keep it straight on the road. All it does is just fishtail because it's so wet outside.
And Ethan did go out. He's got, just so you know, he's got a helmet, boots, all that good stuff. And, well, full gear when he goes to the motocross track.
Yeah, I'm not.
And that's probably what got you thinking about the bigger bike was actually going to the track.
I went to the track and I was like, there was junk probably about the size of the truck and I couldn't make them with crap on the 85. And I got to thinking, I asked my parents if I could get a bike for Christmas, and they pretty much said you can get gear. And then the guy texted me about this, and now I got myself a big bike.
That's awesome. You want to go ahead and fire it up just so they can hear? You can rev it a little bit. Awesome. And it is just pouring like freezing rain out there right now. But if he actually does take it out, it's too muddy out in the yard. He'll dump it. But if he spins it down the road and back or something, I think we might put a GoPro on his helmet and just take you for a little ride. But I told him not to do anything crazy because it is slick out there right now.
I left my driveway and we have an asshole driveway and it wouldn't get traction for crap.
Yeah. Even if you just rode down your driveway and back so they can go for a little ride, I kind of wanted to see what the GoPro does.
It's water-cooled. Well, I guess it would be since it's newer.
Yeah, this thing's new and nice, you know. Oh, they got massive fork tubes on them and stuff. You could jump this thing 20 feet in the air, no problem, you know. That's awesome. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys because that's one hell of a deal for sure.
It's like a full-size version of the other bike.
When I heard him fire it up next door and ride over, Jordan and I both, we thought at best it would be a 250 because who in the world would trade a 450 in this kind of condition for an 85, you know what I mean? It's just like, I'm amazed. I'm really amazed.
These were my favorite part of mine. I didn't have to go back to regular.
And the other bike you traded him was like a Chinese pit bike, basically, right?
I mean, I sent him a picture. I was like, motors, like, destroyed, like, nothing was on the motor. It was just solid motor, no carb, no nothing. And he's like, well, we still have a deal, so.
Awesome. Like, right. He really wanted that 85 for his kid, I guess.
Yeah, and I told him, I said, if I'm driving there, you're not going to. I asked him, I said, if I drive all the way an hour away, we're still got a deal, right? And he said, yes, we do.
Cool. That's cool. Anyway, so I guess that's it for now, unless he's probably going to strap that helmet on right a little bit just for the heck of it. All right, well, anyway, guys, we just wanted to show you that because I just think it's a freaking awesome deal. And obviously, when the weather gets better, we'll have him out back here and he can jump over the hills and whatever. So he's going to head on out and we'll see you later.